Hello guys, I'm Johnny here, back with another video, and today we are going to show you the best way to reuse grocery CRUD. Let's start straight away with the main problem that most of the developers are experiencing by using grocery CRUD. So this is a typical controller, and as you can see, many functions are repeated all the time. So for this, for big projects, this can be chaotic, and if you are in a big project, you all know what I mean. The solution for this is very simple, and that's why I did create this video. Although the solution is simple, it's not obvious, so I wanted to share it with you. So before starting your controller, create a function that at the end of the function, it will return grocery CRUD as object. So because some of you don't know what this means, I simply mean a function like that. So this is get grocery CRUD, and it's returning the object of grocery CRUD. Here you can also add parameters. So for example, you can add the table name and add something like that. Set table, table name. So this means that dynamically you can create the grocery CRUD object, and we've already saved two lines of code, right? So you can use this for your common functionality. So for example, you can use it for set table, set subject, and other parts that you are using. I can show you an example of my function that I'm using. So here it's my function. I have the set table, set subject, the set theme. I have the unset read, and then we have the callback delete that we are using it in order to not actually delete the row. So here is just a simple callback delete, really. But as you can see, because I'm sure that at my database, I'm always having the deleted field, I can use it as a generic function. So let's see how simply we can replace our already existing code. So we are having this, and instead of this and this, we are removing them and say CRUD this get grocery CRUD, and then the table name is office and the subject is office with a capital O. And that's it. So as you can see, if you are reusing a lot of functions, this will save you a lot of time, and it will help you develop faster and smarter. This is a common practice that I'm using, and I wanted to share it with you guys, as it is helping me a lot during the development. If you already have a project, it's worth the time doing that, and it will help you develop faster, I can guarantee you that. And yeah, that's it guys. This practice is helping me a lot, and I hope you find it useful. If you guys like this tip, don't forget to thumbs up the video, and don't forget to subscribe as always. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I speak to you guys to the next one. Bye.